In the previous class, we discussed up to the problem third. Today we are going to discuss it from the problem fourth onwards. Let us see the fourth problem in exercise 10.1. The volume of cuboid is 1200 centimeter cube. The length is 15 centimeters and the breadth is 10 centimeters. Find its height. So, volume of cuboid V equal to how much is given? 1200 centimeter cube. Length of cuboid L equal to 15 centimeters, breadth 10 centimeters. Find its height. So already we know that what is the volume of cuboid? Right, volume of cuboid equal to, according to our discussion, according to our previous discussion, according to our formula, volume of cuboid V equal to LBH. According to our given problem, the volume is 1200 centimeter cube, length is 15 centimeters, breadth is 10 centimeters. Just substitute in this, volume is 1200 centimeter cube equal to, what is the length? 15 centimeters into breadth is 10 centimeters. We should find the value of height, that is h. So we can write as h equal to 1200, same 15 and 10 this side, then it becomes as division 50 into 10. We know the divisions very well. So 0, 0, 15 ones, 15 eights, that is h equal to 8 centimeters. This is the required solution. Next, let us come to the fifth problem. How does the total surface area of a box change if each dimension is doubled? First one. Second, in that second bit also given, each dimension is tripled. How does the total surface area? Actually, according to our formula, what is the total surface area of cuboid? Total surface area of cuboid equal to, already we know that, 2 into LB plus BH plus LH. What is given in our problem, what is given the condition? Each dimension is doubled. Each dimension is doubled means length is double, breadth is double, height is also double. Double means here according to our formula, length is L, breadth is B, height is H. Double means what we have to consider? Length is 2L, breadth is 2B, height is 2H. So if the dimensions are doubled, then length equal to 2L, breadth equal to 2B, height equal to 2H. So now total surface area of cuboid equal to 2 into, what is the length? 2L, breadth is 2B. 2L into 2B plus breadth 2B into height 2H plus L length 2L into height 2H. So according to this, what we can conclude that 2 2's 4LB plus 4BH plus 4LH. Can you take out the common 4? So 2 into 4 of LB plus BH plus LH. So we can write as 4 into 2 of LB plus BH plus LH. From this one we can conclude that if that all the dimensions are double, then the total surface area is 2 into LB plus BH plus LH into 4 is there. Means if the dimensions are double, then the total surface area becomes as 4 times. Therefore, what we can conclude that if the dimensions are double, then the total surface area will be 4 times of the total surface area. Therefore, what we can conclude, if the dimensions are double, then total surface area will increase 4 times. And in this one, another also, second one is also asked, each dimension is tripled. Suppose if the dimensions are tripled, in the fifth one is only second bit, if the dimensions are tripled, if the dimensions are tripled, then what is the length, say, actual length is L. If it is tripled means,
right,
3L. Length equal to, length equal to, directly I am writing, 3L. Breadth equal to 3B. Height equal to 3H. Then, the total surface area of total surface area equal to, what is the economic law formula, 2 into LB plus BH plus LH. Now after triple, the total surface area becomes as 2 into, what is the length, 3L into 3B plus 3B into 3H plus 3L into 3H. So now 3 is 9, 9LB plus 9BH plus 9LH. We can take out common as 9. 9 of, directly I am writing, 2 into, what is remaining, LB plus BH plus LH. Actually it is the, if the length and breadth and height are LBH, then the total surface area is 2 into LB plus BH plus LH. What we have done? It is tripled. Therefore, what we got, the total surface area? 9 times to the total surface area. So, what happened? If the dimensions are tripled, the total surface area becomes as the 9 times to the total surface area. Therefore, if the dimensions are tripled, then total surface area is 9 times to the total surface area of previous cube. Means what we can conclude that if it is twice, that is a double, it becomes as 2 times, then it becomes as a 4 times. It becomes, if it is a triple, that is 3 times, it becomes as the 9 times. From these two, we can conclude that if it is 2 means, double means, it becomes as a 2 square, 4 times. If it is tripled, 3 means, we got that 9 times, that is 3 square. From these two, we can conclude that it is here asked that, can you find area of each dimensions is raised to n times? Already we checked for 2 times, we checked for 3 times. If it is n times, what happened? Can you say? Can you guess that? What happened if it is the n times is increased? What happened?
Right, very good.
It becomes as the n square times.
Right.
What is asking here? Dimensions are raised to n times. If the dimensions are raised to n times, from the above two we can conclude that the total surface area is becomes as n square times. It is our conclusion. Next, if you come to the 6th problem, the base of a prism is triangular in a shape with sides 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm. Find the volume of the prism if its height is 10 cm. So here what is given? Triangular prism. Its base shape is in a triangle and its measurements are 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm. So from these measurements, it is the, from the measurements we can say that it is a right angle triangle. The base is in the shape of right angle. Therefore, we know already the area of base, that is, we have to know the area of right angle triangle. What is the area of right angle triangle?
Right, very good.
R into base into height. And already we know that, how can you find the volume of the prism? Volume of the prism equal to area of base into height. So by using that formula we can solve this problem. 6th one. Equal to otherwise directly we can write as sides of A base of triangular prism equal to 3 cm, 4 cm and 5 cm. Height of the prism equal to h equal to 10 cm. What we want to find? volume of the prism. Volume of prism equal to area of base into height. Area of base into height. What is the area here? It is the area is in triangular shape. The measurements are 3, 4 and 5. That is, we know it is the right angle triangle. From the measurements, we know that it is the right angle triangle. Therefore, what is the area of the right angle triangle? Right, half into base into height. So, it is a right angle triangle like this. What is the base? What will be the base? Base is 3 centimeters. Height is 4 centimeters. Then the hypotenuse is 5 centimeters. Now, according to this, area of base, that is, what is the area of the base? Half into base. What is the base here? 3 centimeters into, what is the height? Height is 4 centimeters. Into actual height of the prism. It is the height means only the base, that is the right angle triangle height is 4 centimeters. Don't confuse here. Next height is, height of the prism is 10 centimeters. Now we can simplify that to 1s, 2 4s, 3 4s, 12, 12 tens, 120. That is the volume of the prism equal to 120 centimeter cube. This is the solution of the 6th problem. Next, if we come to the problem 7, a rectangular square pyramid is 3 meters height and the perimeter of its base is 16 meters. Find the volume of the pyramid. So, what is given there? Height of the rectangular. Height of rectangular pyramid equal to 3 meters. Perimeter of its base. Equal to. Perimeter of its base equal to 16 meters. Perimeter of base means what is the perimeter is in the shape of a rectangle. The height of the square pyramid. Height of a square pyramid is 3 centimeters and perimeter of its base is 16 meters. Perimeter of base, perimeter is in the shape of a square. So, according to our formula, what is the perimeter of a square? That is, right, 4 into a. That is, 4 into a equal to, it is 16 meters. Then, side a equal to 16 by 4, that equal to 4, that is side of the square is 4, height of the square pyramid is 3 meters. What we have to find? Value of the pyramid. Value of pyramid. What is the value of pyramid formula? B equal to 1 by 3 into area of base into height. Area of base into height. So, here we have to find the area of the base. Base is in the shape of square. What is the area of the square? Right, side into side. What is the side A? 4. Therefore, we can substitute this 1 by 3 into what is the side? 4. Area of the base, that is in the form of a square. therefore area of square equal to side into side. Now the side is 4 centimeters, therefore 4 into 4 into height of the pyramid. What is the height of the pyramid is given? 3. That's why I substitute this 3. Then 3 get cancelled. That equal to 4 4s 16. What is given that? Measurements are meters. Therefore it is 16 meter cube. This is the volume of the square pyramid. Now come to the problem number 8. Once read the problem of you. An Olympic swimming pool is in the shape of a cuboid of dimensions 50 meters long and 25 meters wide. If it is 3 meters deep throughout, how many liters of water does it hold? So it is given that Olympic swimming pool is in the shape of cuboid and dimensions are given. That is length of the swimming pool. Length of swimming pool L equal to how much it is given? 50 meters. Width of the swimming pool or breadth. B equal to 25 meters. Depth of the swimming pool, that is height. Depth of swimming pool H equal to 3 meters. What is asking? How many liters of water does it hold? How many liters of water means what we have to find? Right, volume of the swimming pool. That is, swimming pool is in the shape of a cuboid. Therefore, we have to find the volume of the cuboid. Therefore, volume of cuboid equal to L into B into H. What is L now? 50 into, what is B? 25 into, what is H? 3. That is, 50 into 25 into 3. You can multiply. 50 into 25 3 is 75. Now 50 into 75. That equal to 3750 meter cube. 3750 meter cube. But what is asking? How many liters of water does it hold? How many liters of water does it hold? That is 3750 meter cube. 1 meter cube equal to how many liters it will hold? That is 3750 into 1000 liters. That equal to half liters. 37,50,000 liters. It is the capacity of swimming pool. 37,50,000 liters. That is the capacity of the swimming pool. So with this, exercise 10.1 is completed. Now come to the next topic. Right circular cylinder. Thank you. right circular cylinder. Here in your textbook, three figures are given there. You can observe that first figure, second figure, third figure. And you can observe that, is there any difference between among the three figures? If you are observed, it is the first one is the in the shape of cylinder, exactly in the shape of a cylinder. Second one is and third one, it is a base is some crossing is there. The difference is there between the first, second and third. So which one is the right circular cylinder? The first one is the right circular cylinder. Actually, all of we are using the, that is a circle, you know. Suppose if you cut the paper in the shape of a circle, that is a in round shape, that is a circle. If you put number of papers on over each, then it will becomes one by one, it is the becomes as the, it will get some height. That is what is, how can we forming the cylinder? By using that circles, by gathering the circles, we are putting, suppose for best example is, you know, carrom board coins. First coin, and over the coin, put the all the coins put together like this. Then it will becomes as a cylinder. That is the cylinder. So I am showing that it is like this, it is a cylinder. It is a cylinder. So for the cylinder also we have to find the curved surface area, total surface area and the volume of the cylinder. So before that, how can we find that curved surface area or the total surface area or value? Suppose already you know what is the shape of this paper?
Right, rectangle.
In this rectangle, this is the length and this is the breadth. If I fold this paper as a cylinder, that is without overlapping the edges, it is becomes as a cylinder. What is happening here in this cylinder? This is the in the shape of a circle and it is becomes as the circumference of the cylinder or circumference of this circle. So if we open this, the length of a rectangle becomes as the circumference of a cylinder. Length of the rectangle is becomes as the circumference of the cylinder. What is circumference of the cylinder? Or nothing but circumference of the circle. What is the circumference of the circle formula? Already we know from the previous classes. That is, circumference of circle is 2 pi r. So, it is the length of the rectangle is 2 pi r. What is the breadth of the rectangle? Breadth of the rectangle is nothing but, if you fold the rectangle in the shape of a cylinder, the length becomes as the circumference of the circle and the breadth becomes as the height. So therefore it is the height, that is height of the cylinder R is, height of the cylinder is H. Now, already we know that what is the area of rectangle? Base length into breadth. What is the length here? 2 pi R. What is the breadth here? H. Therefore, we can say that curved surface area, it becomes as the total area becomes as the curved surface area. Curved surface area of cylinder equal to 2 pi r into h. Therefore, we can conclude that curved surface area of right circular cylinder, curved surface area of right circular cylinder equal to, according to this, 2 pi r h. This is the curved surface area of cylinder. The cylinder is, it is a curved surface area. X, how can we find the total surface area of the cylinder? So this is the only curved surface area we find. Total surface area means what is more we are adding? Base and the height. What is the shape of the base? Base is in the shape of a circle. What is the area of the circle?
Right.
Square. And similarly, top is also there. It is also in the shape of a square, in the shape of a circle. And the area of circle is, again, it is also pi r square. Therefore, we can say that total surface area is equal to curved surface area plus top and bottom. Top and bottom. That is pi r square and pi r square. 2 pi r square. Therefore, we can say the formula, that is the total surface area of cylinder equal to, what is the curved surface area? 2 pi rh plus top and bottom, that is 2 pi r square. Is there any common? That is 2 pi r into h plus r. This is the total surface area of cylinder. Total surface area of the cylinder. So in your book it is given that, do this, find the curved surface area of each of the following cylinders. What is the first one is given? If r equal to x, r is nothing but, here it is 2 pi r, r is the radius, it is cylinder, no? It is the radius or it is the height, h. In this 2 pi rh, r is the radius and h is the height of the cylinder. So here it is given r equal to x centimeters and h equal to y centimeters. Then find the curved surface area of the cylinder. Therefore, curved surface area of cylinder equal to according to formula, what is the formula? Right, 2 pi r h. So that equal to 2 pi, what is r? R equal to x, what is h? Y. 2 pi x y. This is the curved surface area of cylinder centimeter square. If the second one is given, d equal to 7 centimeters. And h equal to 10 centimeters. Here, what is d? You know already, r is the radius, d means diameter. Very good. So, d equal to 7 means, from this we can conclude that what is r? R equal to half of the diameter, that is 7 by 2 centimeters. H equal to 10 centimeters. Now, curved surface area of cylinder. Curved surface area of cylinder equal to 2 pi r h, that is 2 pi, what is r? R equal to 7 by 2, h equal to 10. 2 get cancelled. Now 7 tens, 75 centimeter square. This is the required curved surface area of the given problem. And third one is also given, you can try yourself. Next is it is given that, do this is given. Find the total surface area of each of the following cylinder. Find the total surface area of each of the following cylinder. Already discussed the total surface area of the cylinder. That is, what is the formula?
Right, 2 pi r into h plus r.
Here it is, figure is given. First one. Do this is first one. This is the radius is given there 7 centimeters and height is given there 10 centimeters. 7 centimeters and 10 centimeters. What do I find? Total surface area of the cylinder. radius of cylinder, radius of cylinder r equal to what is given there, 7 centimeters. Height of a cylinder h equal to 10 centimeters. Total surface area of cylinder equal to 2 pi r into h plus r. So 2 pi, what is r is given? 7 of h plus r, 10 plus 7, that is 7 is 14, pi of 17, that is 17 into 14. You can multiply 17 into 14. How much you will get? Equal to 238.5 centimeter square. This is the total surface area of the given cylinder. Similarly, there is given second one. Radius is given. What is given there? Height is 7 centimeters. There is given circumference 250 square centimeters. That is the circumference is given. So circumference is means 2 pi r is 250 centimeters. Then from that you have to find the r value and substitute in the same formula, you will get the answer. So with this, we are stopping the class, and tomorrow next topic we will discuss, that is the value of the cylinder. On that we will do the next exercise and next topic. We will continue in the next class. Thank you.